everyone, my name is Larry and I'm the creator of Tropic Tankmates. Today we are going back to our angelfish breeding project. We're doing the episode 2 today and I'm gonna show you what are the updates with my breeding. After posting the episode 1 of my angelfish breeding project, I received a lot of questions with my Instagram direct message, Facebook, private message, and here at the comment section as well of YouTube. So one of the questions that I receive is about the RO water. What if I don't have an RO water? There are some cities here in California that doesn't really need RODI because the water coming out from their tap water from their faucet is very soft. But here in my particular city, the water is coming out from the faucet between 300 to 500 TDS or total dissolved with 7.2 in pH, and that is a real hard water. So there are angelfish that will hatch with hard water with no issue, but I preferred using RODI because I have a bigger success rate on it. Here in United States, outside the grocery stores, you will normally see a kiosk machine where you can fill up your empty container for purified water. Also, some of the local fish store, they are selling RODI with fresh water and salt water. So just ask your local fish store, maybe they can help you with that. So the next question I receive is, why do I need to use methylene blue when hatching angelfish eggs? The answer with that is because methylene blue will be a big help to protect the angelfish egg from having fungus. I'm not saying that you will never have fungus on your eggs, but it will have a less chance of having fungus, and you will have a bigger success rate when adding this methylene. So the third question that I receive is, why I'm pulling out the eggs from my angelfish breeder? So my answer with that is, I'm a breeder. Of course, I'm a hobbyist, I'm a breeder as well. To support these many fish tanks that I have in my house, I need to find a way how can I make money, which what I'm doing right now with my angelfish. I'm breeding for profit just to support my hobby. Electricity, water, fish food, and other stuff. And the fourth question that I receive is about fish food. What do I feed my breeding pairs? I'm gonna pull out the eggs from my angelfish breeding tank. Within at least 7 to 10 days, my angelfish will spawn again, especially if I'm feeding them frozen food, live worms, daphnia, and other stuff. Okay, so if I'm not trying to force them to spawn or to lay eggs, so normally what I give them is food from ocean nutrition. So this will keep my angelfish in a better shape. Ocean Nutrition is one of the best company that cater different types of food for your tropical fish. And question that I receive is, what is the size of my breeding tank and why I decided to use that size? So first, the size of my tank is 10 US gallon. The reason why I decided to use that tank is because my fish room is not that big. If I'm gonna use 20 gallon high, I'm not gonna fit like 8 or 10 tanks on my third level of my rack. So that's the reason why I only have 10 gallons. And it works really well for me because, like I mentioned on my previous videos, that my fish room is not that big. It's only about 8 by 10 feet. So I don't have much floor space. Before we proceed with our video, just want to remind everybody, don't forget to hit that like button, and if you're new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you can be notified on my next video. So today is June 26th and here are the eggs that I harvest 3 days ago or a couple of days ago.
As you guys can see, there are wigglers down there. Wigglers. Peruvian angelfish is the most. And this is the Philippine blue angel. I don't have much in there, but yeah, it looks like it's going pretty well. Like I'm having a problem with this pair. So I'm gonna do two things. First, I'm gonna try to change the water into RO. Like I mentioned, my TDS here from my top water is going up to 300, 400, 500. So I'm gonna try to lower down the TDS, the water hardness, and let's see if there's an improvement with their hatch rate before I replace the male. So if that doesn't work, yeah, I'm gonna change the male with a new one. I have some more on my grow out tank. Maybe the male is not good enough or not doesn't know how to fertilize pretty well. Today is 6:29. We are about 6 to 7 days away after we harvest this eggs from my angelfish. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take out 50% of the water and replace it with tap water so we can acclimate the fry from soft water into a hard water. So let's do that by removing the airline. You can also use a suction cup or a turkey baster if you want to, but I'm gonna do it this way. Take out the base. Remove half of it. Make sure there's no fry coming out of the base, because if not, you kill the fry. This is my Philippine blue angel. You see there's some wigglers on it, and there's a lot of eggs that did not hatch. I'm gonna put back this air stone. So we have a continuous agitation into our water. So we're gonna use the airline for drip acclimation. You can see here, I did not pour the water all the way to the base or to my hatchery. It's just because I don't want the fry to get shocked from soft water to hard water. And let's wait until it fill up all the way. Then once I have all this base filled up with tap water, I'm gonna start separating the bad eggs to the wigglers and prepare the fry to be moved into a bigger container. Today is 6:30. You guys remember we harvest the egg 6:22 from my angelfish breeding pairs. So like I mentioned from my previous video, I have 6 angelfish and 4 of those pair spawn at the same time. So here are the outcome. A lot of the eggs did not make it, but look what I have. It's thousands of angelfish fry right now. And we'll see what's gonna happen on the next couple of days.
Alright guys, that's it for my video today, and I thank you so much for your support. And if you have questions, please feel free to comment down below, or you can also send me a message with my Instagram or Facebook. Thank you, and then I will see you on my next video.